Alrighty, time for round two, and well, I'm gonna have to mulligan this hand since it's got no lands. One land would probably be enough to keep this hand, honestly, with Lantern and Bell making sure you hit your second and third land for Spell Scud and Bridge, but instead we'll mulligan into what looks like a very keepable hand. We've got turn one Black Cleave Cliffs Thoughtseize, into turn two Ancient Stirrings, probably Lantern Boggles. Okay, ooh, I have Spell Scud in my hand. Alright, let's see what we're up against. My guess is Boggles, given turn on Dryad Arbor. No, it's Infect. I guess, yeah, Infect may be even more likely. Alright, well. So, Spells get also very good against Infect, as it turns out. Unfortunately, my opponent has double Blighted Agent, double Noble Hierarch, because otherwise that would be one of the cards I would take. I think I do take Noble, though. Since I think Noble is the more problematic card here. Since I would like to find an Ensnaring Bridge. I guess if I have Ensnaring Bridge plus Spellskite, then I'm in pretty good shape. So let's see. Opponent's going to play Noble and no other land. Let's go. I don't need to Spellskite yet. I guess I can start by playing Ancient Stirrings, hitting another Spellskite. And then, though, Gearper either would have been fantastic. My opponent, my library is Abrupt Decay. My opponent's is a Serum Visions. Actually, that's fine. I do need to, at some point, find an Ensnaring Bridge here, but it doesn't have to be this instant. Right, so my opponent is going to draw Serum Visions. They're going to see their top card to get tax improved. That's actually kind of good for me. If their top card is a land, they could just cast Visions, land, Blighted Agent. As is, if they want to cast Blighted Agent, they have to give up on playing a land. And I think I end up... Oh, so they're just going to draw Gitaxian Probe off Serum Visions. Though, actually, I guess this gives them such a high odds, right? Because they get to draw Probe and then Scry 2. And if they don't find a land in there, they're probably pretty unlucky. All right, so they end up keeping Windswept Heath on top. So they're going to Probe, draw Windswept Heath, now play Blighted Agent. I'm going to draw Decay and just keep that, and then play a Spellskite. Groundswell doesn't worry me too much. Their hand right now is two Blighted Agents, Becomements, and Groundswell. Plus, they've drawn one card I don't know about. All right, Glistener Elf. So I need to find... So I guess I just play Spellskite first, because that stops all the Giant Growths. I need to find a bridge. And if I find a bridge, I think I just can't lose. But I need to find a bridge at some point here. Yeah. Well, that was convenient. All right, let's play Spellskite, since certainly having Spellskite in play is the safest. And now I can take two Poison here. And then I can play another Spellskite and an Abrupt Decay on Noble Hierarch, most likely. All right, Serum Visions drawing Wooded Foothills. So my opponent on the play kept Dryad Arbor, double Noble Hierarch, which pretty bad against any deck with Lightning Bolt, which is, you know, 20% of the field, but a pretty fast clock against almost everything else. So probably a reasonable keep, but I was not able to punish them too much. All right, so they put both on the bottom and have Apostle's Blessing on top. And I take two Poison here, which again is fine. And then next turn, because the reason I want to play Spellskite plus Decay in the same turn is I want to have no cards in my hand when I play Ensnaring Bridge the turn after. And so I might as well do that. Alright. Blighted Agent does not concern me. So I draw Ensnaring Bridge. My top card is Pyrite Spellbomb. Nice, nice. Alright, so I can play this. The next turn I can draw Spellbomb and play Bridge Spellbomb. So I'm going to pass the turn now and probably going to end up decaying. Still just the Noble Hierarch. I can't imagine wanting to kill anything else. Because the Blood Agents just get to stop attacking in a turn here. And Noble's going to be the only thing that can even possibly attack. So they probably should attack with both Blighted Agents, just safer. I mean, I could decay the one, but I don't really see a reason to do that. All right, yeah. All right, I'll take some more poison. Go to four poison. I guess my opponent... Actually, it was supposed to decay earlier, right? Because of Apostle's Blessing. That actually doesn't matter too much. I mean, I should have done it. There's no reason to give my opponent an opportunity to use this Apostle's Blessing. But I then, because I have Pirate Spellbomb, but there's, yeah, there's no real reason to give them reason to give them an opportunity. All right, so now let's play Bridge. Play Spellbomb. And I think that's just game. I mean, I don't know how my opponent can get out of this. Certainly no cards we've seen. They don't get to attack with anything ever again. And I even get to Surgical Extraction, probably Noble Hierarch, just to make sure. Turns out, Infect doesn't like to see Spellskite, because it slows them down, and certainly does not like to see Ensnaring Bridge, because a turn two or a bridge with no cards in hand, I mean, my opponent's just now got three pump spells in hand. All right, so let's draw. I still have to cast all my spells here, so I'll stop my opponent's draw step, because I'll let them draw Vines here. That doesn't bother me either. Actually, I don't even need to stop it on their draw step. I could just let them draw Vines. Oh, well, now I'm going to wait, because they're sacking the Wooded Foothills. All right, they can draw Misty Rainforest all they want. Pendlehaven. So I guess in the beginning of combat, I do have to cast this Extraction, though. So I will do that. All right. Pay a black. Like I said, I'm still getting Noble Hierarch because I think that's the only card that particularly concerns me because it can attack even with a bridge on zero. Opponent's hand again, three pump spells. I'm going to get two more Nobles. So now my opponent has two Spellskites that can attack. Okay, I've got to worry about those. Yeah, Spellskite is actually somewhat of a legit concern, so keep that in mind and a bunch of pump spells. And that's it. All right. All right, my opponent is just off it. I mean, they're not going to win with Spellskite either, but at least it was a possibility. All right, so now I definitely want Aether Good. See, this is one of the maps where Aether Good is great. I don't want Surgical Extraction because I don't like that card. I do want Pyroclasms. The question is, do I want Welding Jars or Needles? Needles stops Blink Moth Nexus, which is reasonably valuable. Pyroclasms is clearly very good. Pirate's Bomb, also good. Welding Jar could be interesting here because Welding Jar, my opponent's going to have cards like Nature's Claim in their deck, I would imagine. I don't expect Grudge normally. And I mean, I believe I want all the lock pieces. I could take out one of the Hand Disruption pieces. I don't think that's completely outrageous. And I guess Life doesn't matter, so I'll just take out an Inquisition. All right, I'll try that. All right, what do I got here? A hand that really wants a red, but I'm going to keep this hand because it's got Spellskite, which again, just buys me so much time. I can cycle off Spellbomb. And Snaring Bridge is also obviously quite important. Part does not have a one drop. I like that. All right, I do think I lead with Pirate Spellbomb, though, because I'm not just going to be randomly like Codex Shreddering. Until I have the actual Lantern, I'm not super worried about milling people because it just doesn't really do any good. I mean, it's better than not with Academy Ruins, but still. Is opponent going to Nature's Claim Pirate Spellbomb? Huh? Okay. I mean, I'm in. I can't even activate it. I guess I could have cycled it at some point. So now my opponent's going to play Blighted Agent, presumably, because if they had Glistener Elf, they would have played it turn one. Yeah, I don't see them keeping a hand without any of those cards. All right, I'm going to play Spellskite. If they have another Nature's Claim and a bunch of pump spells and I don't draw a red mana or a third land, I guess those are kind of the same. Then maybe I'm in trouble. But if I draw a third land, I can go, ooh, Twisted Image. Yeah, that's pretty good. If I draw a third land, then I get to play Bridge followed by a bunch of one drops. Though I guess this Pyroclasm, if I don't draw red mana, then I could get stuck holding the bag, or in this case, the Clasm. All right, Groundswell, I'm getting hit for five. Yeah, that's a fast clock. And Glimmer Void, nice. All right, so now let's play Pyroclasm. And I believe Ghoulcaller's Bell to give myself more ways to mill here, or more things to pick up with Academy Runes. I couldn't go Glimmer Void go to get back Spellskite. I think that's pretty bad. All right, I could just be dead now to this Nexus. That would be a shame. There's a lot of cards that kill me though, so I'm actually wouldn't be surprised if that's the case. We'll find out in a second here, but all my opponent needs is a Vines, a Become Immense, or a Groundswell. It looks like a become immense. I guess gold-colored bell helps fuel that too, so. Alright. Looks like we're on to game three here. Yeah, maybe Welding Jar is good. Maybe I don't need all the lock pieces because I have so many cards that lock them out that I don't need to go full on Lantern here. I mean, needles still do seem good to me. I mean, I want all the lanterns clearly. I guess I could take out like two of the shredders, put in two welding jars, and stoke off the five hand disruption spells. It is kind of annoying that they have Twisted Image for Spellskite, but what can you do? Alright, I would like to play first, and. Well, that's a good keepable hand. It's got a grid. Unfortunately, Nature's Claim kills the other grid as well, but if it doesn't, if they don't have Nature's Claim, then I think they're just super dead. Alright, I'm gonna play Lantern first so I can get the most information possible. Alright, Twisted Image. Well, I guess I know not to play my Spellskites until I've successfully Thought Seizures or Inquisition my opponent's Twisted Image. I wish Welding Grid could protect Aether Grid, or Welding Jar rather, not Welding Grid. And let's see if my opponent has a turn one Glistener Elf. If they have Glistener Elf, I imagine I pick it off with Pyrite Spellbomb. And hope that my. Actually, I have the Mox Opal land. I can't even. Alright, let's go Pyrite Spellbomb, Mox Opal, Ghoul Caller's Bell. I think I'm okay with my opponent drawing Groundswell, but let's try to kill the Glistener Elf first. If they have Mutagenic Growth. Alright. If they didn't have Mutagenic Growth, I would be less okay with that, but I'm fine with my opponent drawing the card Groundswell. I don't think that's gonna defeat me here. Alright, so now I really want my opponent to tap out for a Blighted Agent so I can just go grid and nail your Blighted Agent. Alright, well, Glistener Elf works too. Do I want to mill? I don't really want to draw Mox Opal. I really want to draw Inquisition or something along those lines. Ghost Quarter is actually decent too. And I'm fine with my opponent drawing Become Immense. So let's play grid. And my opponent just has to have Nature's Claim or they're locked out. If they don't have a Nature's Claim, they can just never kill me with any amount of infect creatures, especially since I have a Ghost Quarter for that Nexus, which would be their next available chance. Opponent has to have like Mutagenic Growth into a kill spell here. Or Apostle's Blessing, I suppose. Alright, they do not. So in that case, I'll let them draw Become Immense because I have even Ghost Quarter up for protection. So their hand is now Become Immense Groundswell. And I'm going to draw, and I think I'm going to be okay with Pyrite Spellbomb. Just another layer of protection here. Gear up her Aether Grid, just doing work. Alright. Yeah, you can attack me. I'm not going to sack Ghost Quarter to prevent one damage off Nexus. And I'm fine with my opponent drawing Breeding Pool. Alright, Lanar Waste, play Pyrite Spellbomb, and pass the turn. Alright, draw Breeding Pool. Vines, you can draw Vines also. So now I'm definitely not in a in such a good position that I want to risk it. I think I just let my opponent. I just untap and draw Tendo Ice Bridge. Because I don't really want to mill my opponent with Ghoul Caller's Bell and see something bad for me. All right, do I want to draw Ancient Stirrings? What does that do for me? Yeah, I don't think I need to. I think I'll just pass. I'd rather just keep the Pyrite Spellbomb because what I could do there is draw with Pyrite Spellbomb the Ancient Stirrings. Then if I had to use Bell, I wouldn't lose the Ancient Stirrings. But I think this is okay. This is going to be a tough sell, I think. So I think I just take this, and I'm gonna try to kill the Nexus. Don't worry, but I would rather just take it. That way, if something goes wrong, I don't just die, because now I get to Aether Grid at end of turn. And if my opponent has a pump spell, then that's fine. I get to grid again, and I still had a Ghost Quarter. I mean, I had like millions of backup here, but there's no reason to risk it. My opponent doesn't have a Poison Fireball in their deck. Twisted Image. All right, let's kill it again, I suppose. No reason to give them a draw step. All right. That fizzles. That fizzles. I draw Ancient Stirrings. My top card is Spellskite, though, so I just draw Spellskite. My opponent clearly doesn't have anything here. So I'll just let them draw. They have now Forest in their hand. Blighted Agent on top, which is A-OK. I'm just going to draw Spellskite. All right, let's play Spellskite, make sure it's good here. It is. Now I'm going to just cast my Ancient Stirrings. draw, probably just take ensnaring bridge here. I don't need another lock piece. And maybe I could take another lock piece there, but I think if I just play bridge, my opponent has multiple permanents they have to kill. Now they have to kill Spellskite first, then they have to kill grid, then they have to kill bridge in order to win the game. So I think they're just well and thoroughly just locked out here. Now I can start gridding my opponent to death. I wasn't really worrying about it before, but might as well now. Draw Mox Opal. Doesn't do anything for me, but doesn't hurt. I really don't want to mill. I'm fine with my opponent drawing Windswept Teeth. They drew Windswept Teeth, they still have Windswept Teeth there. And they're taking three a turn off the grid. I wouldn't call them off the grid, but I'm pretty much on the grid at this point. Opponent is just dying very quickly. All right, let's draw Glimmer Void. Not that that's very good, but my draws just don't matter at this point. Ooh, Academy Ruins even more back up here, since now my opponent's got to kill like five different things without basically without getting draw steps at this point. I mean, I'm gonna have a stop set in case I want a Ghoul Caller's Bell, but there's so few cards I care about. Inkmoth Nexus certainly is not one of them. And my opponent doesn't have a ton of time. I mean, Aether Grid is a clock. It's not the deck doesn't specifically need a clock, but it is a clock, and in this game it was amazing. It picked off Glistener Elf and Inkmoth Nexus and Glistener Elf. So yeah, that was pretty good. The one of grid did some work. Opponent probably taking mental stock, which you do against this deck often, figuring out what are my conditions to win the game. And part of the depressing thing about playing against this deck is you know you've lost the game for so many turns before you actually lost the game. And technically, my opponent could draw like seven cards in a row to get out of this. I mean, at this point, they probably don't have the time, but in a normal game, that is kind of the case. So I can actually just kill my opponent here with grid, 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 untap, grid, 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 Pyre's Bellworm. So 2-0.